Hello, creative humans. It's Watercolor Week here. Now, before we begin, there's a common misconception that you have to have the correct or right and expensive tools to create beautiful watercolor pieces. I'm going to show you some tools that might be lying around your house that will help to make the process easier. So, a lot of watercolor artists use traditional watercolor paint palettes that have wells. I'm going to show you my trusty watercolor palette. I made it out of an egg plate. This is my favorite paint palette to use because of all the little wells. And I purchased a few others for that specific reason. I don't even have a traditional paint palette lying around my house. Now maybe you don't have a glass dish, or maybe your parents won't let you use their nice ceramic deviled egg dish for paints. I also purchased some around Easter for 98 cents from Walmart. So any little egg dish or tray that has little compartments will work well for watercolors. Because watercolors are liquid, you kind of want those wells just so your colors don't mix. Worst case scenario, if you don't have anything similar to that lying around, wrapping a plate or bowls in aluminum foil will protect your plate, and you can just dump this, rip it off, remove it when you're done painting. I love my watercolor paint brushes. Paint brushes traditionally used for watercolor are made of sable or a natural hair because they need to hold water and pigment. If you don't have any paint brushes lying around, you can use any clean makeup brushes. These will do the trick. In our next videos, we are going to show you how to create watercolors from food coloring, acrylic paints, as well as dried markers. In terms of colors, you really only need the three primary colors, and those are red, yellow, and blue. The three primary colors create the entire color wheel. I'll show you some examples that I've used in my past classes. So here's the entire color wheel created by just using the three primary colors, as well as creating neutrals, so browns, pastels, and chromatic black. So stay tuned. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to create watercolors from dried up markers. Stay tuned.